So, welcome to our DigitalU webinar. And if you want to ask a question, we're pretty informal here. So just raise your hand to ask a question or type in the chat box, which is down at the bottom. And I have Jeremy Stroud here with me today offering tech support. So if you're having any trouble hearing or seeing what's going on, please give a shout out to Jeremy. And there's his phone number, email, and he's also here via the chat. I'm Jennifer Fenton from the Washington State Library. And this program is brought to you by the Washington State Library with our Institute of Museum and Library Services funding. Thank you, Jeremy typed in his phone number and email there in case since the slide is no longer up there. So, it's my pleasure now to introduce our speaker today. Charlotte is joining us from the Yakima Valley Libraries, where she is the Community Library Resource Manager, and she is here to talk about social media in libraries. Welcome, Charlotte.
Thank you. This might be pretty quick this morning, so if you have any questions, definitely let us know. Social media in libraries, is this what we're supposed to do, Jennifer? Sorry, it's my first rodeo here.
Yes, you are right on target.
Okay, just making sure I wasn't missing something. Social media in libraries, as I like to call it, the necessary evil. Here we go, figuring this out here. There are a multitude of different platforms available. I prefer the free platforms just because we're all facing budgets and issues. I presented something similar at WLA with a group from Seattle Public and Kitsap Regional Libraries. So I've kind of adapted what they're doing because different platforms fit different areas. For example, Seattle Library uses Twitter quite a bit. And in Yakima, it's not as huge of a following. So you can use Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, YouTube, whatever you can continually update that and you get the most followers on, that's what we would suggest. And a couple things about Twitter. Twitter is a faster moving platform than most, and it's basically it's a conversation. It's like a text conversation where you need to be able to be responsive to people at any given time. People will tweet everything, from questions to complaints to ideas. As you can see here, you know, somebody had a DVD out, but it wouldn't play in the DVD player, and they're looking for a response. And I know that Seattle Library itself has a social media team. Smaller libraries like my own, we don't. It's me. So you just have to be able to balance it as well as you can. You know, I think that everybody has a different perspective on how to handle social media. I say it should be about a 70-30 split. 70% of the time you should be talking about your culture, who you are, being funny, engaging people, and 30% of the time you should be, you know, selling them your product, whatever that might be. Is that your story times? Is that, you know, Overdrive, whatever that is. So figure out what works for you. For example, Seattle Public Library talks about, you know, their different story or their different children's library areas, and that's important to people. But if you always post about your books or your branches, people will stop following you, unfortunately. And it's important to have humor. Not the inappropriate humor that's going to get you in trouble with your boss, but the kind that engages people and makes them want to follow you because they think you're something more. And there's a number of ways to be online. LinkedIn, Flickr, Instagram, WordPress is a great blog site, Constant Contact, Google Places. These are all things to be aware of. You don't necessarily have to have an organized presence on them, but you do need to somewhat monitor them because social media is an interesting conversation. We were talking about it at WLA a couple weeks ago, and social media is like the mean girls in high school. They're already, it's already out there. It's talking about you. It's in, you know, you're already, you already have a presence, and so you need to invite yourself to the conversation. One of the most important things about social media is to be human. Show people who you are and what makes you unique and why they should come in to not only your branch, but to visit your employees, to be your patron. You're marketing yourself, and it's just another platform for that. Some people, like Kitsap, they have a scheduled post that goes out every single day at, I think it's 2 or 3 p.m., One of the things I will warn you about with scheduled posts is that if there's something irrelevant going on in the world at that time, sometimes those can come back to bite you. So, for example, if you would have had a scheduled post the day of the Boston Marathon bombings and it came out within half an hour of the bombings and you weren't referencing those, you were saying, you know, we love to read, working out until my arms hurt is my, or reading until my arms hurt is my workout. That may not go over very well, and that could actually turn around to bite you. So if you are going to schedule your post, make sure you're aware of what's on there and you're still paying attention to the world outside. I feel like I'm moving through this quite quickly. I'm really sorry, you guys. If you have any questions, please let me know. One of the other important things that you can use your social media platforms for is promotion and feedback to find out what people think, because people are brutally honest on social media for good and for bad. So one of the stories I always like to tell is that you don't think about having to monitor your online presence until something negative happens. And one day we had a Craigslist rant about us at Yakima Valley Libraries, and it was a very well-spoken, very well-educated man who was very upset that we had time limits on our free computer use, and he berated us via Craigslist, and it was something that was really important to me, so I brought it up to the director, and we actually addressed him, you know, via his Craigslist post, and he went back to apologize on there, which is a huge deal for somebody to do via social media. But it's important to know that people are out there talking about you, and they'll tell you exactly what they think. You just have to ask sometimes. So, for example, Kitsap here was looking to monitor or to upgrade their library. So what did they want to do? They wanted people to tell them what they wanted as far as patron use and design, things like that. So we've used, in Yakima, we've used this to promote our strategic planning survey, to promote feedback on events, the big read. You can also use social media to create book discussion groups. Facebook is a fantastic way to do that. So you can actually discuss different aspects of a book via Facebook group, which is a free way to engage people. The nice thing about various types of social media is that you can somewhat monitor your outreach. Obviously, people are going to see it and not really engage. You know, they're going to be there, they're going to hear, but they're not going to listen, vice versa. But you can actually monitor how many people are talking about your programs or talking about your posts or your pictures or sharing them. So here's some examples of some Facebook analytics. I know that there's companies that you can contract through for Twitter and different types of social media to engage and to compare them. I like what's free because budgets are limited, and I think that you can pretty much get the same idea. One of the things that's become really important to Yakima Valley Libraries is to start a conversation with people. We do outreach all the time, and we participate in different organizations or different things that are already going on in our community. We have different community partners. So one way that we reach out to people and gain new fans or new likes is to engage the community groups that we are participating with. So example you can see on the left there, Yakima Valley Libraries was with Yakima Area Arboretum, and we made sure to tag them in the post so that we could also reach out to their fans. Seattle Public Library took advantage of the Super Bowl and posted pictures of the parade, which was a huge outreach opportunity in Seattle that day. And then the other thing that I like to do is use social media to make corrections or to, I don't know how to say that very nicely, but to make corrections or to fill in information gaps. We're currently doing a $400,000 renovation at one of our 17 branches, and the story that KIME News did for us left it very open-ended. So we wanted to make sure that people understood that not only are we being progressive, we're fiscally responsible, we're not part of the city, because a lot of people were really concerned that the city was spending money on the library when there were other cuts being made in the city. So we used the opportunity there and monitored the comments to see what people were taking from the story, and then turned it around to gently correct the news station while engaging them. You know, thanks for the story, KIMA Action News. We're proud to be part of a progressive and fiscally responsible agency that's working towards serving the needs of our community. It's a nice way to correct and guide the story in the way that you want it to go. Another thing to make sure that you're doing with social media, which is probably the most time consuming, is to stay apprised and relatable. So if it's Banned Books Week and you're using Pinterest, for example, make sure that you're talking about Banned Books Week leading up to it. What are they? You know, you can, Pinterest is an interesting concept because it's basically a corkboard of opportunities. So you can pin recipes, you can pin back to your website, you can create your own pins, you can, you know, repin other stuff. So it's a whole plethora of opportunities for you there. So what I've done is we've talked about creating a blog. Blog is really time consuming, and you may not have time to keep it updated. So we created a YVL Librarian Recommendations Board. So as librarians read books or recommend books, we pin them to our Pinterest board rather than having them blog about them. It takes a lot less time. It's, you know, anybody can do it. All they have to do is email me a title and I can put it right on there versus them having to sit down and spend 30 minutes to compose a blog that then somebody else is going to read, and we're hoping that a patron picks it up. Apparently we are very fast this morning because I did all the talking. So are there any questions or comments? Jennifer, any questions or comments?
So what's been your most successful experience with social media in Yakima?
You know, every social media aspect is a little bit different. When I started with libraries, I wasn't sure what people followed. I'd always worked in emergency services prior, and people were always seeking information from me. I wasn't necessarily trying to push it out. So the most successful experience I've had currently is with Facebook, and I'm actually working on a project now to kind of convert our Big Read discussion groups into Facebook groups, which will be very nice for our book groups that are outlying. We have 17 branches and we span nearly 5,000 square miles, so it's not necessarily conducive for all of us to meet in one place. So I would say Facebook is probably the most successful outreach for us. But one of the best things that I can suggest is if you don't know what people are using, ask them, because they will tell you what they're using. I went to a basketball tournament and asked the kids who were running the score clock, what kind of social media do you use? And they all told me Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. And Snapchat's not very conducive to our world because the messages disappear. So you're going to spend some effort and some time, and then the message is not going to go anywhere. But that's my suggestion. If you don't know what the people in your area are using, just ask them because they'll tell you.
Thanks. And have you had any security or privacy concerns expressed as you enter this world?
As far as, like, pictures being used?
Well, that or just people worried about privacy or issues of security with opening up your computers to social media. Any concerns either from the staff and administration and or from the public?
No, we haven't had so many concerns or issues with that. We have had some discussions and some lengthy discussions about what kind of pictures we post and whether or not we operate via copyright or how we get around that. There's always a little bit of a little hesitation when you're using social media with copyrights or without. What can I share? What can I not? My suggestion is that if you can share it from a page, which gives the other page credit, you should always do that first. If you're copying and pasting a picture and it has some sort of watermark on it or copyright mark, don't remove that to put your own on because you're obviously going to be in copyright infringement at that point. You're committing the act of it at that point. As far as posting pictures of people, you know, you can go a couple different ways about it. I always try to get the backs of heads if they're kids, just because it makes me feel better as a parent. Our policy is that the library is a public place. You know, we can take your picture and use it. I understand why some people would not necessarily want their kid's picture randomly on a Facebook page or, you know, in an Instagram feed. So I try to be respectful of that. If I know I'm going to be taking pictures of an event and I put it out there, I will put a sign up that says, you know, if you do not want your picture taken, please express that.
Thank you. Jeremy, did you have any questions?
No. I put my mic down, sorry. No, not really. I'll admit, social media is one that I play with a little bit, but I've never really got too terribly involved with it. I tend to talk face-to-face with my friends instead. I don't work with it here on a professional level, so I don't have to worry about that side of it.
Yeah, it's definitely an interesting concept, and I hate to say it that way, but it's a necessary evil because people are on there. They're on there all the time. They're checking in. They're engaging you, and they're waiting for you to respond. So I always tell people that it's a lot like going to a middle school lunchroom. You know, you choose where you sit, and you choose who you engage, and you just have to make the decision whether or not you're going to engage back or you're going to invite yourself to the conversation. Jeannie, are you currently on any platforms of social media? Okay. Personally or for your library? Do you guys have a lot of success with it, or is it just kind of a new situation? And is there any questions I can answer for you? Oh, KidsApp is fantastic with their social media. One thing I will say that's different about KitSap versus Yakima is that KitSap pays there's an option in Facebook to pay to promote your posts. And Kitsap actually pays, I think it's like $10 a day to post and promote it. And that's you can gain a lot of followers and a lot of fans, and a lot of people can see it when you pay for it, but you have to budget for it. So that's always an option. Yeah, she is. She's fantastic. I presented with her at WLA, and she's really great at what she does. So,
well, thank you so much, Charlotte. Is your contact information on the slides, then, in case people who watch the archives have questions for you?
I don't think so. How do I post that on there?
You can add it in the chat, and then that will show up in the chat. So that should work.
All right.
Well, thank you so much for doing the webinar.
Yeah, thank you.
Archive, so tell people about it.
All right. Sounds good.
I will post my
contact information, and if anybody has any questions, they can email me.
Great, and thank you. Thank you, Jeremy, for being our tech support. We appreciate it.
Always more than happy to help.
Fantastic. Have a great day, you guys.
You too.